the difference between a sequence and what a series. A sequence, when the numbers are arranged and they have a given, there's a defined relationship or pattern that exists between the terms of the number, we call it what? A sequence. It can be common difference or common ratios. But when we talk about series, series is the addition of what? A sequence. Which means that a sequence that have T1, T2, T3, T4 as the terms in the sequence, the series will be T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus T4. Let's move to the next example, please. Let's move to the next example. Okay, let's take the next example. I'm taking the next example on sequence and series. Now, this question we're going to take now is going to carry. We're going to be asked to calculate sequence, calculate from sequence and series. Sequence and series. Okay? Okay, so we are good to go. Okay, you ready for the next question? The next question is, find the series of the first, okay, find the series of the first four terms. Find the series of the first four terms. Find the series of the first four terms. That's number two. Find the series of the first four. Find the series of the first four terms. Find the series of the first four terms of. Now the nth term of the sequence is given as find the series of the first four terms. The series is given as 2 raised to the power n, okay? Now 2 raised to the power n plus 4n squared. 4n squared. 2 raised to the power n plus 4n squared. So find the series of the first four terms. Now this is the nth term, which is tn is equal to what? 2 raised to the power n plus 4n squared. Now we are required to look for what? We are required to calculate what? The series of the what? First four terms. Now getting the series means that we're going to calculate the sequence first. Now the sequence, now t1 will be equal to what? 2 raised to the power 1 plus 4 into bracket 1 squared. Now 2 raised to the power 1 will give us 2 plus 4, 1 raised to the power 2 will still give us 1 times 4 will give us 4. So that will give us 6, okay? Because 1 raised to the power 2 is the same thing as what? 1 times 1, which is equal to 1. Okay, this. Now 4 times 1 will give us 4. Now 2 raised to the power 1 means 2 raised to the power 1 is 2, is 2. 2 plus 4 now will now give us 6. Now T2 will give us what? 2 raised to the power 2 plus 4 into bracket 2 raised to the power 2, which will be equal to 2 raised to the power 2 is what? 2 times 2, which is equals to 4 plus 4 into bracket. 2 raised to the power 2 is what? 4. 2 raised to the power 2 is 4. It means 2 times 2. So we will now have 4 plus 16, which will give us what? 20. How do we get the 16? We got the 16 by using 4 to multiply 4, which is 16 plus 4 will give us what? 20. Then we look for T3 is given as 2 raised to the power 3 plus 4 open bracket 3 all square. Now 2 raised to the power 3 is what? Is 2 times 2. 2 times 2. No. Is what? 2 times 2 times 2, which will give us 8. That's 2 raised to the power 3. It means 2 in 3 places. Okay? So 2 raised to the power 3 give us 8 plus now 4 into 3 raised to the power 2 means 3 times 3, which will give us what? 9. So you have 8 plus 4 times 9 will give us what? 36. Now, 8 plus 36, let's add. 8 plus 36 will give us what? 44. That will give us 44. That is 43. Now, T4 will give us what? 2 raised to the power 4 plus 4 into brackets. Okay. 4 raised to the power 2. Okay. Now, let's continue. Remember, we are always putting, substituting into the place where we have n, calculating the n for the various terms of the sequence. We have 2 raised to the power n plus 2, 4 raised to the power n squared, okay, as the n term. So calculating for the 4 term now, T4, we give us 2 raised to the power 4, a place where you see n, you put 4, plus 4 into black. Anyway, you see n, you put 4 again, that is what we have been doing. So that means this will equal to 2 raised to the power 4 is what? 16, which is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, 16 plus 4 into brackets. Now, 4 is part 2 means 4 times 4, which is 16 also, will give us what? 16. So this will give us, now from here we have 16 plus, now 16 plus 4 times 16, that will give us what? 64. It will give us 64. Let's check it out. Let's check it out and be sure. Easily check it out. Okay, let's remove this question and check the multiplication to make sure that we are correct. Okay, now let's go using your long multiplication method. You have 16 times 4, so 16 times 4, 4 times 6 will give us what? 24. Put down 4, carry 2, 4 times 4. We was 1 plus that, so we was 64, so we're correct. Now 16 plus 4 is going to give us 80. That will give us, you can check it out also by saying 64 plus 16, 4, 6, 4 plus 6 will give you 10, put down 0, carry 1, 6 plus 1, 7 plus that one, 80. So we are very correct. So these are the what? The terms, the sequence of what? These are the first four terms of the sequence, the first four terms. Now the question says we should calculate the series. We should find what the series of the first four terms. Now what do we do? Now we have sequence, which is what? T1, T2, T3, and T4. Now T1, by calculation, T1 is equal to 6, T2 is equal to 20, T3 is equal to 44, now T4 is equal to what? 80. So T1 is 6, T2 is 20, T3 is 44, T4 is 80. Now I'm going to put it in series. Now putting it in series means that that's the sequence there. Now series, and putting it in series is going to be a series. Now series is going to be T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus T4. Now what do we do? What we've calculated, we're going to bring it down now so that it can be in form of a sequence. Now in form of a series. Now the series actually now will be 6 plus 20 plus 44 plus 80. This is the series.